On this vlog, we're going to be talking about how much is too much of one stock in your portfolio. Hey everybody, welcome back to our YouTube channel and our vlog. Today we're going to be talking about how much is too much of one particular stock in your portfolio. Should it be 1% of your assets, 5%, 50%? What is the right number? Well, the answer is there really is no right answer, but there is an amount that's probably too much for most people. Now, again, everybody's situation is different, so you need to understand your own specific situation, and I'm going to give you some things to think about today to help you determine how much is too much or too little for that matter. Most of the time when I meet clients that have a concentrated position in a stock, it's usually because they work at that company. So here's some things to consider. Number one, think about, are you going to accumulate more shares going forward? So for example, if you have a $1 million portfolio and $100,000 of your portfolio is in one stock of the company you work for, that may be an appropriate amount today, but you may be given grants or stock options, so you're getting a lot of stock given to you. And if you can calculate how much that's going to be over the next several years, it may end up consisting of 30 or 40% of your portfolio when you fast forward 5 or 10 years from now. So take that calculation into consideration. And really, how much is too much? I would say that, you know, probably somewhere in general, around 10 to 15% is an appropriate amount. I meet people sometimes that have 50% of their total investments in one stock. And there's a great benefit of doing that if the stock goes up. And of course, there's a great detriment if the stock goes down. A classic example would be Enron going out of business. Now, there are a lot of great companies have gone out of business. And so you do have concentrated risk. Number one, if you work for that company, because not only is your job tied to that, your income tied to that company, but also now your net worth and your investments are tied to that company. So you might diversify from that standpoint. But I think 10 to 15% is a good number. But you do have to ask yourself, what is the primary reason that I own 10, 15, maybe 20% in your case of one particular stock? Is this the greatest stock you've ever seen? Are you taking undue risk with your capital? And those are some things to think about because, again, you can wake up, a stock can be down 10 or 20% because of a bad earnings report, because they replaced the CEO. There's lots of reasons why the stock could fall. There are benefits, obviously, of owning a concentrated position. Number one is that if you sell it, you may have large capital gains, so keeping it may be more beneficial. And obviously, if the stock goes up tremendously, it can add a great deal of value. I recently met a client with a huge concentrated position in one technology stock that he's had since the early 1990s. And he's gone through some wild swings, as you can imagine, during the dot-com bubble, during the 08 financial crisis. But most of his net worth has happened because of this stock going up. So in his case, he's been rewarded. But now as he looks to retirement, we're making that transition to starting to diversify a little bit more because the benefits of that stock going up are not near as great as the detriment of that stock falling. He's about to retire. His income's going to stop. He's obviously going to have Social Security, but his primary income's going to go away. So he's going to be using his portfolio to live off of, and having it fluctuate dramatically because of one stock in there is just not prudent. So while you're younger, it may be a time to have a little more of a concentrated position. There's tax consequences, but the main thing to figure out, as you always do, is the strength of the company and also how many shares are you going to continue to accumulate over the next several years. Calculate that. Once you figure out that number, then you can put a good game plan together in terms of how much is too much of a concentrated position in one stock. Thanks, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Take care. We'll see you next time.